Vaivacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadara Shri Vasati Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. So we're speaking on the Srimad Bhagavatam by the mercy of our founder Acharya, His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Srila
Prabhupada.
We're continuing to speak from the fifth canto. Now we're going on to chapter number 15. The glories of the descendants of King Priyavrata. We heard about Priyavrata at the beginning of the fifth canto.
我们在开始的, 几篇之中,
he was. There were two sons of Manu and Satarupa. Manu and Satarupa had two sons, Uttanapada and Priyavrata.
Manu 有两个儿子, Priyavrata 和
Uttanapada.
Uttanapada.
Right? Uttanapada was the father of Dhruva Maharaj.
Uttanapada 是这个朱瓦马哈拉吉的父亲.
So remember Priyavrata, he was he'd gone to the mountains with Narada Muni, and he wanted to be in the mountains, but they convinced him to go back and become the king. So he went back, became the king, became married, and he had children, and later on, at the end of the life, he renounced.
Okay.
So this chapter begins talking about the descendants of Priyavrata. And the first one is coming from Priyavrata. We have Maharaj Bharat. Maharaj Bharat, remember, was the son of Rishabhdev, and Rishabhdev came in the line from Priyavrata.
Priyavrata后面的有一个国王叫做Rishabhdev，Rishabhdev是来自于这个Priyavrata传系的。
This Maharaj Bharat, he was the most famous son. Rishabhdev had 100 sons, and Maharaj Bharat, he was the eldest.
Maharaj Bharat 是他的这些孩子之中最为优秀的，也是最为年长。
Rishabhdev had 100 sons.
Rishabhdev 有100个儿子, Maharaj Bharat 是其中最年长，也是最出名的。
Right. So he had a son, Maharaj Bharat had a son. Before he went to the mountains, you know, he retired very early, he went off to the mountains, so he had a son.
Maharaj 在去山上之前也有一个孩子.
But Maharaj Bharat went to the mountains, he renounced everything and went to the mountains.
Maharaj 去到山上他 他弃绝了这一切，弃绝了家庭生活。
So he left his son to become the king.
他留下他的儿子作为国王。
His son was called Sumati.
他的儿子的名字叫做Sumati.
So some people, they think Sumati was Lord Buddha, but he was not.
有一些人认为苏玛提是主佛陀，但是他不是的。
So people who are atheistic and who have a bad character, they will have many problems to understand the message of the Vedas.
有一些无神论者和一些品质比较低劣的人，他们去理解这个伟达经的时候是非常糟糕的一种行为。
These kind of people, they will accept Lord Buddha.
这些人，他们接佛陀。Or
they may accept this son of Bharat, this Sumati. Sometimes they accept him. They think he is Buddha.
或者他们也接受这个Sumati，这个Bharat的儿子，他们也把他认为是佛陀。
And they think everyone should follow the same principles they did.
他觉得所有人都应该追随同样的，他们就是他们同样的这种教的。So
in the Kali Yuga, we know we get a lot of bad philosophies.
在卡利年代，我们有太多的这种不好的哲学。
People don't really know the meaning of the Vedas.
人们根本就不知道伟达经的真正的含义。But
they claim that they know.
但是他们声称自己他们知道。And
they don't follow the acharyas, but they have their own acharyas.
他们不追随这个。 先前的灵性导师，但是他们有自己的灵性导师，
and they put
them,
they make their own acharyas. They say we are the real followers of the Vedas.
他把这个灵性导师搬出来说，我们是真正的伟达经的追随者。But
they don't follow any Vedic principles.
但是他们不追随伟达经的这些原则。
They have no relationship with Lord Buddha.
他们和这个布达根本就没和佛陀根本没有什么关系。
But they claim they're following Buddha.
但是他们声称自己是这个佛陀的追随者。
And some of them they claim they're descendants. They're coming from Lord Rishabhdev.
还有一些人，他们说是说自己是来自于主Rishabhadeva的这个后代。So
Vaishnavas, those who are really devotees, they should have to be very careful to avoid their company.
所以，作为Vaishnava奉献者，应该很小心避免与这些人接触。Krishna
says in the Bhagavad Gita, in the 15th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said, the purpose of the Vedas is to know me.
主 Krishna 在《伯伽梵歌》15章中15世节说道：“伟达经的真正目的在于了解我。”Krishna
says, "Sarvasya chaham bradisani visto matakshmitir gyanam apohanam cha vedaischa sarveraham eva vidya." Vedanta Krit Veda Ved Eva Chaham. Krishna says, from me comes knowledge, remembrance, and forgetfulness.
主 Krishna 说，我处在每一个人的心里，记忆、知识、遗忘都由我而生。
By all the Vedas, I am to be known. I am the author and I am the compiler of the Vedas.
研习所有伟达经，就是为了了解我。实际上，我是维丹塔苏特的编纂者，我精通一切伟达经典。So
this is the injunction of the Vedas.
这是伟达经的这个目的。So
people should understand how great Lord Krishna is.
人们应该知道这个主 Krishna 他有多么的伟大。And
Lord Buddha is an incarnation of Lord Krishna.
主佛陀是这个主 Krishna 的一个化身。
And Lord Buddha had a, his own method to spread the philosophy of Bhagavad Dharma.
主佛陀他有他的一套特别的教导，教授这个 Bhagavad Dharma 永恒的职责。
Because Lord Buddha was preaching to people who were all atheists.
因为主佛陀的传教对象是无神论者。
And atheists, they don't want any God.
无神论者根本就不想要任何的神。
So Lord Buddha said, "There's no God."
所以佛陀说根本就没有神。
But he actually, Lord Buddha didn't teach about God. He didn't say there's no God. He didn't say there is God.
事实上，主佛陀都没有教导关于神。他不仅他说的是，他根本就没有提神这一块。
But the people who were with him, they were all atheists. They couldn't understand God.
但是他的追随者，这些无神论者，他们可以理解神。
So the teacher has to know how much the students can understand.
一个老师他可以知道他的学生在多大程度上能理解这一回事。
So Lord Buddha knew that his students were all atheists. They can't understand God.
所以主佛陀知道他的这些学生都是无神论者，他们根本无法理解神。
So he found the best way to benefit them.
所以他发现了这种特别的方式，对于他们非常有益的这种特别的方式。
Yeah, he just told them, "You just follow me."
他告诉他们，只是追随我。
And he's God. He's an incarnation of God.
但佛陀他就是主本人，他是主本人的化身。
So by following Lord Buddha, they got the benefit of surrendering to God.
因此，通过追随主佛陀，他们得到了受益。
So this is how Lord Buddha tricked the atheists.
这就是主佛陀他怎么样欺骗的这些无神论者。
According to everything has to be done according to the time and the place and the circumstances.
一切的教导根据时间、地点和这种特别的情况而定。
We see how Lord Jesus preached very simple things.
我们看到耶稣他传也是非常传播的，也是很基础的。
Jesus, he simply taught, love thy neighbor as thyself. Think of the neighbor, you know, love your neighbor. Don't fight with them. Don't kill them.
主耶稣的教导是爱你的邻居，爱他们，不要去伤害他们，不要和他们争斗，不要杀害他们。
He taught also about.Don't commit adultery. Be faithful to your wife.
他还教导不要变得那么的怀疑，对你的妻子要有信心。
Yeah. Don't go taking other women. Just be satisfied with one wife.
不要和另外的妻子发生关系，只是满足于一个妻子，满足于自己的妻子。
So Jesus taught these simple things, very basic.
所以耶稣他教导的也是这些很基础的东西。
And similarly, also Prophet Muhammad, he also taught very basic things.
穆罕默德也教导一些很基础的理论。
Because they were preaching in places where people were not much educated.
因为他所传教的地方，人们受教育的程度并不是那么的高。
So they have to teach according to their ability of the people to understand.
所以他传教的时候会根据人们的这个能力、理解能力来进行传教。
So I was giving class the other day to devotees in Africa, and we were talking about.The different incarnations of Krishna.
前几天我给非洲的一些奉献者讲 Krishna 的一些化身。
Yeah, it was a verse from the third chapter, first canto Bhagavatam.
在圣典薄伽马坛的第一篇第三章有描述。
So devotee asked me a question. He said, why is there no mention about all these incarnations in Christianity or in Islam?
所以当时有一个学生就问到，为什么这些化身没有在这个天主教、基督教或者伊斯兰教里面提到这些化身的名字呢？提到这些化身呢？
So I told him how these people in the time of Muhammad and Jesus, they are not so educated. They could not understand much about God.
所以我告诉当时这个学生，因为在之前的这个年代，穆罕默德或者说基督那个时代，人们的受教育的程度并不很高。人们并不理解神。
Just for the simple things which Lord Jesus taught, he was crucified.
只是遵循基督的一些教导，人们就可以。
No. You see, Jesus taught very simple things to the people. Simple, very basic.
耶稣教导人们都是非常非常基础的。
But when the people heard,about what Jesus was teaching, then they decided to nail him on a cross.
Nail him on a cross.
On the cross, you know, they have that shizu, right?
十字路口.
No, they put the nail through the hand and the feet, and they put Jesus on there.
当人们接受了这个主耶稣的这个教导之后，他就把这个十字架放到这个手上。
No. anyway, they killed Jesus for what he taught.
Okay, good. 人们当时接受了耶稣基督，但是最后又把耶稣基督给钉在了十字架上。
Yes. okay.So, you see, preaching can be dangerous.
所以我们看到这个传教是非常危险的。
Many preachers, like Haridas Thakur, he was also beaten for his preaching.
我们看到哈尔达斯塔库因为传教也被鞭打。
So,we have to be sensitive to the time and the place and know how to present the philosophy.
我们也应该非常敏感小心根据时间地点的这些情况去如何传播我们的哲学。
So I explained to the African devotees about how people have a very limited understanding about God.
所以我向非洲的这些奉献者学生讲述了人们是如何有他们的知识非常匮乏以至于很难以理解神。
Just like Christian people, they have difficulty to understand that animals also have a soul.
就像基督教的一些人他们很难理解动物它也有灵魂。
They think the soul in the animal must be different from the human being.
他们认为动物体内的这些灵魂一定和人是不同的。
So they have like it's people have to understand the basic spiritual knowledge to understand the energies of God.
人们应该了解关于神的一些基础的知识，了解神的能量。
Yeah, if they want to understand about God, first they have to understand more about who they are and understand the nature of the soul, the body and the soul.
要想了解神，他们首先应该了解他们自己本人是谁，他们的灵魂的这个身份。
So, to understand God's incarnations, people have to be a little more civilized, a little more advanced.
要了解主的化身，人们应该更加的变得更文明、更精进才行。
Therefore, Jesus and Muhammad didn't teach about these things.
关于耶稣和穆罕默德，他根本就没有讲述教育这些事情，教育这些知识。
But if we think about it, we can understand God is not limited; He is unlimited.
如果我们仔细的去思考这些的话，我们可以理解主他不是有限的，他是无限的。
So, if we are limited with our body, but God's body is not material.
我们是有限的，因为我们的这个物质躯体，但是主他不是物质的，他是无限的。
And with his unlimited powers, he can appear in any different form.
由于他无限的能量，他可以显现任何的形体。
And he can perform inconceivable pastimes.
他也可以从事非常不可思议的逍遥时光。
But unfortunately, people are not spiritually educated.
但是不幸的是，人们并没有得到恰当的教育。
And when they think about God, they try to understand him with their mind and senses.
人们思考神的时候，总是通过他的心意和感官去理解这一切。
We give the example about the frog in the well.
我们给予了一个例子，比方，就好像一个青蛙在井里面一样。
Right, the frog in the well meets another frog, and the frog says, "I went to the ocean." So the frog in the well asks, "How big is the ocean?" Is it three times as big as my well? Is it four times as big as my well?
当一个青蛙遇见另一个青蛙，他们在井里面的时候，其中一个青蛙说：“我到外面见过了这个海洋。”那么另外一个青蛙就问他：“海洋有多大？它有我的这个井的三倍大吗？四倍这么大吗？”
And so the same way we try to understand God is God.Twice as big as me? Is he three times as big as me? We are trying to understand him with our limited mind and senses.
同样的，我们去理解神的时候，也会用我们这有限的心意和感官去理解。我们会想着，神有我两倍这么大，有我们三倍这么大吗？
We have to know God has unlimited, inconceivable potencies.
我们应该理解神主他有无限的不可思议的能量。
So this is a very important principle to try to understand God.
这是理解神一条非常重要的原则。
Okay, so we hear about different kings. There was one king, Pratiha, whotaught about self-realization.
有不同的国王，叫 Pratiha 的这个国王，他讲了觉悟自我。
And he not only purified himself, but he purified many others.
他不仅净化了自己，而且还净化了很多其他人。
And he became a great devotee of Lord Vishnu.
他也还是主威士努一个非常伟大的奉献者。
And he was able to realize the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
他能够觉悟到至尊威士努。
So we have to understand that God is not just some imagination or just something which we think is there, but it's not real. God is actually real.
我们不能认为主他只是一些我们想象出来的，事实上主真的就在那，他是真实存在的。
So this king Maharaj Pratiha, he did spiritual practice and he realized Lord Vishnu.
国王 Pratiha, 他获得了觉悟到至尊主威士努。
And then he became a preacher. He taught people how they can also become self-realized.
通过修习，他不仅自我觉悟，他还成为一个传播者。
Just like
他告诉别人如何觉悟自我。
In the Bhagavad Gita, it describes about approaching how you approach the spiritual teacher.
在《薄伽梵歌》也讲了我们该如何去接近一位灵性导师。
Right, famous verse, chapter 4, verse 34. Tadvidi pranipatena pariprasnena sevaya upadeshyanti te jnanam jnaninas tadvadarsana. Just try to learn the truth by approaching a spiritual master. Inquire from him submissively and render service unto him. The self-realized soul has seen the truth and can impart knowledge unto us.
努力皈依灵性导师，学习真理，寻隐于难，全然顺从，而且为他服务。自觉的灵魂因掌握了真理，故能受灵以知识。
So in that verse from the Bhagavad Gita, it describes the qualification of the spiritual teacher.
在这个诗节里，我们也看到一位灵性导师的资格是什么？
First of all, that he has seen the truth.
首先，他是见过真理的。
And the second thing is that he can show the truth to other people also.
第二个，他也能向别人展示真理。
Some people say, I know the truth, but I cannot explain it to others.
有些人说，我见过真理，我觉悟到真理，但是我不能给你传授真理。
So that's not the real teacher.
所以这不是真正的老师。
But the real teacher, he's seen the truth himself, and he can give the knowledge to help others to see the truth.
一个真正的老师是他自己能见到真理，同时他能给予别人知识，让别人通过这个知识见到真理。
So this is actually a qualification of the spiritual teacher.
这就是灵性导师的资格。
So people who want to distribute Krishna consciousness and become spiritual masters, they have to take that responsibility to teach people the truth.
所以一个想成为灵性导师的人，他应该承担起这个责任。给予别人以真理。
Yeah, it's not enough to just, you know everything yourself. You have to also teach. You have to be able to reveal it to others.
不要仅仅只是自己去了解一切，而要帮助别人，向别人揭示这一切。
So our Krishna consciousness movement puts a lot of energy into these kind of activities where we're going out and meeting the public and trying to give spiritual education knowledge to them.
我们 Krishna 知觉的运动也花很多的精力和时间去到外面给予别人这样的知识，教育别人。
There's two kinds of paths of self-realization.
关于觉悟自我的道路有两条。
One is doing what we would call their own spiritual practice, and the other is they're going out and meeting other people and educating and sharing with them, discussing with them. One is called Gostavanandi and one is called Bhajan Anandi. So the Bhajan Anandi, one who does Bhajan Anandi, they don't preach. They only chant the Hare Krishna mantra themselves and they just do their own bhajan. They only worship themselves. They go away from everybody.
有两种觉悟自我的道路，一种是自我修习，叫 Bhajan Anandi。他们只是自我唱诵 Hare Krishna 进行崇拜，他们远离人群，自己一个人在休息。
But the Gostavanandi process, which is encouraged by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is to go out and distribute Krishna consciousness.
但是 Goswa Nandi 是被 主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 所教导的, 是我们到外面去传播, 给予别人 Krishna 之举。
We see Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu spent 6 years traveling around India. Wherever he went, he was distributing Krishna consciousness.
我们看到主柴坦尼亚马哈帕布花了六年的时间在印度旅行，他去到任何一个地方都给予别人Krishna之举。
Wherever he would meet people, he would tell them to chant the holy name.
无论他遇到什么人，他告诉别人唱诵主的圣名。
And he taught everyone that they should read the books about Krishna.
他还告诉别人，你们应该 阅读 Krishna 的书籍,
and they should worship Krishna.
你们还应该崇拜 Krishna,
and should chant the holy name of Krishna.
你们应该唱诵主 Krishna 的圣名.
And Lord Chaitanya did this same thing by his example.
主柴坦尼亚以他的榜样做了同样的这些事情.
So we follow the teachings of Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya said, you don't have to change your position, your ashram, your situation. Stay where you are and just hear about Krishna.
主柴坦尼亚说,你不用改变你的现状和位置,待在你现在的这个地方,你现在的这个状态,但是唱诵 Hare Krishna.
Yeah. We need to concentrate, put our effort into chanting the holy name and worshipping Krishna and learning the philosophy of Krishna consciousness.
我们应该专注地把我们的努力用在唱诵 Hare Krishna, 学习 Krishna 的这个哲学, 同时崇拜 Krishna.
Krishna consciousness is in everyone. It has to be awakened.
Krishna知觉在每一个人内心，但是需要被唤醒.
We have to let people hear about Krishna.
我们得让别人聆听到 Krishna.
So some people say, oh, you shouldn't preach, you shouldn't go around everywhere preaching, you should just be Krishna conscious yourself.
有些人说，哦，你不应该到处跑，你应该专注，你应该好好的具有 Krishna 知觉.
But it is compassionate to go and give Krishna consciousness to others. That is real compassion.
但是如果你把 Krishna 知觉给予别人，这是真正的怜悯.
Okay, so then we hear about Maharaj Gaya.
然后我们听到这个Gaya国王.
Gaya was very famous and he was very pious, he was a very saintly king.
Gaya是一位非常虔诚、非常有名而且非常 圣洁的国王,
and he was a direct expansion of Lord Vishnu.
他事实上是主威士努的直接扩展.
So he was situated in pure goodness.
他处在超然的善良形态之中.
So, and he also has perfect, he has transcendental knowledge.
同时他也有超然的知识.
So he was understood to be a Mahapurush.
同时他也被称为 Mahapurush.
So there are many different kinds of incarnations of God.
主有很多不同的扩展.
Some come directly and some come indirectly.
有一些是直接的, 有一些是间接的.
So Krishna is also Mahapurush.
Krishna 也是 Mahapurush.
devotee is sometimes called Maha Purushika.
奉献者有时候被称为Mahapurushika.
If someone comes directly from Lord Vishnu, then they are Vishnu Tattva.
如果一个人他直接从Vishnu那里扩展出来，他被称为Vishnu Tattva.
Just like in the Panchatattva, we have three Vishnu Tattva.
就像Panchatattva神像中，我们有三位Vishnu Tattva.
We have Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, and Advaita Acharya.
我们有主Chaitanya、主Nityananda，还有Advaita Acharya.
So for the Vishnu Tattva, then we can offer Tulsi. We can put the Tulsi on their feet.
对于Vishnu Tattva, 我们可以把图拉西叶放在他的莲花足下.
But we don't put Tulsi on the feet of those who are not Vishnu Tattva.
但是我们不把图拉西叶放在不是Vishnu Tattva的足下.
Just like we are Jiva Tattva, we're not Vishnu Tattva, we are Jiva Tattva.
就像我们自己，我们是属于Jiva Tattva, 我们不是Vishnu Tattva.
And so Jiva Tattva means living entities, ordinary living entities.
Jiva Tattva的意思是个体生物.
So this King Gaya, he was very good as a king because he gave so much protection to all the people.
Gaya 国王他非常好，好在于，他不仅保护人们，还给予别人。
He made sure that even the different elements, the undesirable elements of the material world would not disturb his citizens.
他甚至保护那些动物都免于被打扰。
No, he made sure that things like earthquake and famine and disasters didn't trouble his people.
Oh, 他保护人们免于这种自然灾害，比如说地震、天灾等等这些情况，使人们免于这些灾害.
Right, and he also made sure that there was always sufficient food for all the citizens.
他还保证人们有足够的食物给予老百姓.
And sometimes he would give gifts to the citizens to please them, to satisfy them. And sometimes he would have meetings and call all the people, all the citizens to come, and he'd speak nice words to them all. And he would tell them what they need to do so that they can be their very first-class citizens. So Maharaj Gaya, he was a really great king. And of course, king is a householder. But he strictly followed all the rules and regulations of householder life. He did sacrifices. And he was a pure devotee of Krishna. And the citizens all called him the Mahapurush.
他的这个百姓称他为 Mahapurush.
Because he was giving so much facility for all the people, they were so grateful to him.
因为他满足了臣民的一切便利，他们非常的感激.
And then at the end of the life, at the end of the life, he became a very strict devotee of the Supreme Lord.
In his life's end, he became a very 严格的奉献者。
He always gave respect to other devotees.
他总是对于其他奉献者尊重。
And he practiced the Bhakti Yoga process.
他从事风曼瑜伽的修习。
So he had no attachment. He was free from the bodily conception of life.
他没有这种躯体化的概念。
He had realized the Brahman, so he was always happy.
他觉悟到 Brahman, 他所以总是非常快乐。
He didn't know anything about lamentation, about material distress.
他没有任何的物质悲伤。
And although he was perfect, he was not proud.
虽然他非常完美，但是他从来不骄傲。
And he wasn't anxious to be the king. He didn't worry, he didn't really care about being the king.
他对成为国王也没有这种迷恋和焦虑。
So the king is the representative of God.
国王是至尊主的代表。
He may be a human being, but he's the representative of God.
虽然他是人类，但是他是至尊主的代表。
So he has two duties. He has to deal with the demons and keep the law and order, and he has to give pleasure to the devotees.
他有两个方面的职责。第一个，他keep along with demon.
Yeah, he has to remove the demons.
Okay. 他要杀掉这些恶魔，同时他要保护他的臣民。
The demons often give trouble to the ordinary people.
这些恶魔总是对百姓进行骚扰。
And they can, when the demons give trouble, then it can disturb the production of food.
当恶魔来骚扰的时候，这个 农民的这个粮食的产量可能就会有影响。
So the king has to make sure the demons don't give trouble.
所以国王要保证这个 demon, 这个恶魔们不来骚扰。
So because the king is taking care of all the people are happy to pay taxes to the king.
因为国王非常保护臣民，所以人们也非常乐于给予税收。
So the king, because he's taking taxes, he's also responsible when the people do something sinful.
当国王去向市民征税的时候，他也应该为老百姓的罪恶活动负责。
So in the Kali Yuga, the kings are all influenced by Kali Yuga. It's mentioned in the Ramayana that Ravana had a brother named Vibhishan. And Vibhishan was a great devotee of Lord Ramachandra.
维比闪是 Ramachandra 一个非常伟大的奉献者。
And Vibhishan made friends with Lord Ramachandra.
维比闪也和主 Ramachandra 成为了朋友。
He didn't fight for Ravan. He left Ravan and he came and joined Lord Ramachandra.
他离开了 Ravana, 然后加入到主 Ramachandra 这边。
So some of the army of Lord Ramachandra, like Hanuman, they were doubtful. They thought, oh, he's Ravana's brother. We don't think he can be good. We cannot trust him.
在主 Ramachandra 这边，比如说像 Hanuman, 他对这个维比闪有一点怀疑。他觉得他是 Ravana 那边来的，他可能并不友好。
So Vibhishan,
我们并不能相信他。Vibhishan
made a promise. He said, if I do anything to harm you, he said, if I do anything to go against you, to cause you harm, He said, then in my next life, I will become a Brahmana or a king in the Kali Yuga.
So, Vibhishan, 为了显示他的这个诚意，他跟主 Ramachandra 说，如果出于偶然或故意，我对主 Ramachandra 有任何伤害或伤害到我们的友谊的话，他将被诅咒成为卡利年代的一个 Brahmana 或国王。
Because Vibhishan knew that in the Kali Yuga, both the kings and the Brahmanas will be very fallen people.
因为 Vibhishan 他知道，在卡利年代，这些 Brahmana 和国王都是非常堕落的。
So actually, practically, Kali Yuga, there's no real kings or real Brahmanas in the Kali Yuga.
事实上，在卡利年代。根本就没有真正的 Brahmana 和国王。
Only pretenders, cheaters, not real kings, not real Brahmanas.
只是一些欺骗者，根本就没有真正的婆罗门和国王。
People pretend that they're a king or a Brahmana. They think they're a Brahmana. They think they're a Brahmana because they wear a Brahman thread.
人们认为他是一个婆罗门，他只是挂着一个圣衣线，但其实他们都只是假装的婆罗门或者国王。
They don't have any qualities of the Brahmana.
他们根本就没有婆罗门的品质。
But they think I'm a Brahmana because I have a Brahman thread.
但是他挂着一条圣衣线，他觉得他自己就是一个婆罗门。
So, Maharaj Gaya, he was a real.Representative of Lord Vishnu.
Maharaj Gaya, he is the real Vishnu, the real representative.
So he was a real Mahapurush.
He is the real Mahapurush.
Okay, we will stop here today. Ask if there's any question.
好，我们今天讲到这儿，想问一问大家有什么问题吗？
先等两分钟吧，暂时还没有问题提上来。
No questions, huh? Everybody gave questions all day and they don't have any more questions.
Guru 说大家白天可能问问题问的很多了，现在就没有问题了。
Haribol?
我有一个问题，就是关于这个 Ramachandra 里面，Rama 主 Rama 的逍遥时光里面 ，Hanuman 的灵性导师是谁呀、
啊、？Hanuman 的灵性老师，
对。
Well, Lord Rama is always the guru of Hanuman.
Oh.
Hanuman's the loyal servant of.Lord Ramachandra, he doesn't know anybody else but Lord Ramachandra.
Okay.
It's completely devoted to the service to Lord Ram.
Mm-hmm. Okay. 我问到这个主哈努曼的灵性导师是谁？故事说，哈努曼他是主永恒的主 Rama 永恒的仆人，他除了 Rama 之外谁也不知道， Rama 总是跟他在一起。好，第一个问题来自于 Mathura Nila Madaji， 顶拜 Guru， 请问 Guru 在初级阶段是应该重视自己的修行，还是也要花一些时间去传教呢？ Obeisance to Guru Day，
In the near five.
So this, yeah, in the near five class, we should use most of the time to self practice, or we also need some cost some time to preach.
Yes, you should also go out for preaching sometimes. It's very good for you.
是的，你也需要花一些时间去外面传教，这对你非常有用。
嗯。So, if you just stay in the temple all the time, you don't go out, you don't know what it's like outside the material world.
如果你只是在庙里面待着的话，你根本就不知道外面到底发生了什么。
It's very important for us to go preaching, because then we get to use whatever knowledge we have, we get to practice explaining about Krishna consciousness to other people.
去传教的时候非常好的一个原因是因为我们去传教的时候可以去运用我们所学到的这些知识给予别人。
So our process is thatWe learn a little bit, and then we go out and preach. And then we learn a little more, and then we go out and preach. And by preaching, you get more realization.
我们的这个系统是，我们学习一点，然后去传教，然后再学一点，然后再去传教。在传教的这个过程中，我们会学到更多。
So it's very important for us to get some experience in explaining what we've learned.
我们去传教的时候是非常重要的，因为它能够让我们体验到我们所学习的这些知识。
We may think we know something, but we don't really know it until we were able to explain it to others.
我们认为我们自己觉悟到了一些知识，事实上除非我们去向别人解释，去传教的时候去解释，否则我们真的无法体验觉悟这些知识。
So it's very good that we go out sometimes and talk to people and explain Krishna consciousness to them.
因此非常好的非常好，如果你能够花一些时间去外面给予传教的话是非常好的。
If we just stay in away and stay out of the, if we don't go out preaching,We forget about how much suffering and how much misery there is in the material world.
如果我们不去传教的话，我们根本就不知道外面的这个世界他们遭受了多大的痛苦。
We're just in our own little world, we have our own little apartment, and we're sitting comfortably, and we forget about what's going on.
我们只是待在自己的小房间里面，我们只是关注着自己的一切，但是我们忘记了外面到底发生着什么。
So it's important to go out and see everything and meet people and talk to people in different situations.
因此非常重要去外面传教，我们可以见一些人，了解到他们的处境是怎么样的。
And then we become more conscious when we're studying, we become more conscious and we make greater efforts to understand everything properly so that we can explain it to other people.
所以非常好的是我们做一些努力学习，然后我们去传播，让别人能够恰当的理解。
We don't know about all the bogus philosophies which people have and all the crazy ideas people have and how confused people are.
我们不知道别人到底困惑的是什么，别人的内心的想法是什么，那别人到底误解的是什么。
So very important that we spend time, we go out preaching also.
所以这也是我们出去传教的一个很重要的一点。
And then at the same time, we study, we try to study in advance, learn more, and then try to teach more, explain more.
与此同时，我们也去学习更多的学习。
So from the beginning, new devotees coming to Krishna consciousness, they can also go out for preaching.
在最初的，就是作为一个初级奉献者，他来到 Krishna 知觉，他也可以去外面传教。
Yeah, we often take new devotees.Out, and they go out for preaching, and they distribute books, and they talk to people.
我们也带着这些初级奉献者，让他们去外面派书，让他们去见一些人。
It's a very good learning experience for them.
对于他们来说，这也是一个学习和体验的很好的方式。
So we encourage devotees.You know, go out, do some preaching.
所以我们鼓励奉献者去到外面做一些传教。
Of course, at this time, it's not so easy to go out for preaching.
当然，这个现在这个时刻去外边不是有一些困难。
Of course, I see devotees. They go out. They distribute food. They go for food for life, doing food for life, distributing prasada.
但我们也看到一些奉献者 他到外面去做这个 food for life, 派发一些菩萨的。
So sometimes maybe you can go for food for life and you can also preach there.
或许你也可以去做一些 food for life, 就派发菩萨的活动。
Sometimes we have book tables around Mayapur and devotees go to they stand at the book table and they talk to the people coming and introduce the books to them.
有些时候有一些奉献者他站在这个书架的这个前面，他向别人介绍这些书。
So that's nice preaching.When you get people to take some book, one of Prabhupada's books, it's very good preaching.
如果有人能够得到帕帕德的书的话，这也是一个很好的传教。
Okay, is there any other question?
Next question, yeah, yes. Next question from Janaka Prabhu. 请问 Gurudev, 有一些在经典中提到的非常有名的国王和婆罗门。他们好像也是卡利年代的，是不是说，只是说现在这个卡利年代没有合格的婆罗门或者国王的？I want to ask Gurudev, there are some very famous king and brahmanas mentioned in the sutras. They seems to be also in the Kali Yuga. It seems that whether.Just in this Kali Yuga, there are no real brahmanas and kings.
No, in every Kali Yuga.
不，每一个卡利年代都没有合格的国王或者婆罗门。
Yeah. The kings we were reading about today, they're not from Kali Yuga.
我们今天阅读到的这些国王，他不是来自于卡利年代。
Bharat Maharaj and Rishabdev, these people, they're not from Kali Yuga.
Bharat Maharaj, Rishabdev, 他们不是来自于卡利年代。
Lord Ramachandra, he's not from Kali Yuga.
主 Ramachandra 也不是卡利年代的。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from the Rajendra Prabhu. Rajendra Prabhu, 传教危险，没有人需要冒风险，除非他特别爱孤乳。如何根据时间、地点、听众的不同，传播的内容也发生变化？ So preaching is very dangerous. No one needs to take risk unless he is Krishna and Guru. So how to depend on the time, circumstance, and the audience. We preach the different contents.
One has to be expert to judge.
一个人应该非常专业的去评判。
But before you meet people, before you try to preach to people, you want to get to know them, to understand them.
当你要去传教的，传教面对一些人的时候，你首先要了解和理解这一些人是怎么样的情况。
Just like you want to know, are these people new devotees or are they old devotees? How long have they been devotees?
就像你会了解这些奉献者是初级奉献者、中级奉献者，还是说一些很老的奉献者
？What kind of background are they coming from?
他们的背景是怎么样的
？Are they educated or not?
他们是否受过了一些教育呢
？It will be different for different people.
不同的人是不同的。
So we want to know, we want to understand the person you're going to preach to them. First of all, you have to get to know them.
你要去传播的话，先了解这些人是怎么样的。
If you don't know the person, it will be difficult to know how to present teaching properly.
如果你不了解这些人的话，你无法恰当的给予他们。Rajendra Prabhu also asked the first question is the preaching is very dangerous. No one to take the risk. He asked if whether this person loved Krishna and the Guru very much. Then he like preach and take the risk.
Well, yes, devotees do take risks to go for preaching.
是的，奉献者去承担一些风险去传教。
But you have to be cautious. You have to be careful in some sense. You don't want to be foolish that you just don't take any care or any caution.
他去传教，但是他不要变得那么的愚蠢，去在任何的情况下都没有意识的去传教。
Just like if you know there's a tiger in the jungle, you don't go in the jungle.
就像你在这个森林里面遇到这个老虎，你不会去拥抱这个老虎。
You have to be sensitive to the particular.Situation.
这是一种很特别的情况。
那 Prabhupada came in Calcutta, and when Prabhupada came in Calcutta in 1970-71, at that time there were many, there was a communist movement, and they were trying to take over.
圣帕帕德1971年的时候来到加尔各答，当时那个是。共产党在接手了这些事情。共产党的管理。
They were not in power, but they were trying to get power.
他们当时并没有那么多的权力和力量，但是他们想夺得权力和力量。
And many big businessmen had been killed.
当时有很多的大生意人都被谋杀了。
So Prabhupada was having a festival there in Calcutta.A big pandal, a big program.
当时帕布帕德在那个时候有一个大的一个帐篷的一个活动。
And Prabhupada met with the people, with these communist people. He spoke to them and You know, he told them what he was doing.
帕帕就遇到了这个当时的共产党的这些人，跟他们讲我们正在做什么。
He told them this is spiritual communism.
圣帕帕的说，我们这是灵性的共产主义。
And he let them also, he gave them chairs, and he didn't have them sit on the floor, he let them sit in chairs, he gave them nice treatment, and they became friendly to Prabhupada.
圣帕帕德并没有让他们坐在地上，而是给了一个椅子，给他们很好的招待。
So you have to know how to deal with the people, with these people, in these situations, you have to be careful, you have to be diplomatic.
所以我们应该很小心地了解我们要传教的对象，然后与他们恰当的相处。
Yes, there is danger, but there's danger everywhere in material world.
是的，很危险，但是呢，在物质世界到处都有危险。
A devotee takes shelter of Lord Krishna.To protect, for protection.
奉献者托庇于 Krishna, 希望 Krishna 保护他。
Prabhupada quoted the verse, "Padam padam tad vipadam natesham." How there's danger in every step.
圣帕帕的引述这个诗节，说明如每一步都存在危险。
But if we take shelter of Krishna, then.The material ocean becomes very small, very insignificant.
但是如果我们脱避于 Krishna 的话，物质世界非常渺小，微不足道。
And we can easily cross over beyond it.
然后我们可以很容易地跨越它。
Okay.
Okay. It seems that Rajendra Prabhu asked, when preach, it is said, preach is very dangerous. So someone preach, it means that he loves Krishna and Guru very much. Yes?
Yeah.
是的，如果一个人传教，他去承担这些风险的话，这代表了他是爱 Krishna 和 Guru 非常深的。
We hope so. We hope that he's going preaching with a pure motive.
我们希望他传教是带着这种纯粹的动机。
Some people just go preaching for name and fame, for their own name and fame.
有一些人传教，他是为了名誉和名声的。
Some people go preaching for their own profit. They want to get some followers or to get money.
有一些人传教，他是为了追随，他是要追随者和钱的。
So different people have different motives. Not everyone is pure, that their preaching is just for Krishna and Guru.
不是每一个人都是纯粹的，他的传教，不是说每一个人的传教都只是为了 Guru 和 Krishna. 每一个人传教都有他不同的动机。Rajendra Prabhu also asked, how to preach in Mayapur, except, Internet lecture, what we should do?
Well, I said in Mayapur, when everything is normal, then there's a lot to do. There's a lot of Harinam Sankirtan going around Mayapur.And there's a lot of book distribution to people coming to visit Mayapur.
当马雅普一切都正常的时候，我们事实上是有很多事情要做的。比如说，我们把书派给这些到访者，我们去围绕着周边做哈利纳姆桑基尔坦。
So there is always things to do in Mayapur, usually, but at this time.Even at this time, there's food for life, goes out every day, goes to different parts, different villages.
即便在现在这个时刻，还有很多的服务要做，比如说还有很多的派发普沙等生命灵粮的活动，他们会到各个村庄去派发普沙等。 Next question, Gurudev.
Yeah.
Next question from Shamki, Dimai, Gurudev 和所有的奉献者。当我们遇到有的人承认主 Krishna， 却不承认主 Chaitanya 和 ISKCON 还有圣帕帕的爷爷，他们说主 Chaitanya 是大笨蛋，我们是智慧欠缺才修习 Krishna 之觉。我们用经典和他们辨别，当他们辨不过我们时就生气。我告诉他们，世界的圣人都追随主 Chaitanya， 我们也追随这些师徒传系的先辈Acharya。Guru， 下次遇到这样的人，我们是不是不该理他们而远离他们？我们只相信那些，他们只相信那些歪理邪说。Obeisance to Guru and devotees. When we see some people, they admit Krishna. They admit Krishna, but they don't admit Lord Chaitanya and ISKCON and Srila Prabhupada. They say Lord Chaitanya is foolish and we are lack of knowledge. So then we practice Krishna consciousness. We use the sastra to speak with them, but sometimes they will be angry. I tell to them, all the sages, they all follow Lord Chaitanya, so we also follow this Sampradaya and Acharya. So Gurudev, when next time I meet them, shall we not speak to them and be far away with them, because they just trust some no sastra.
Yes, better to ignore them.
是的，忽略他们。
Better, 最好忽略他们。Better just to leave them alone and not to go near them because they're not willing to hear.
是，让他们一边待着就好了，不要聆听他们的这些东西。
There are people like that. I know there are people like that. They don't want to hear philosophy. They don't want to hear our teachings. They have their own ideas.
我知道有一些人是存在这样的，他们不喜欢聆听这些我们的哲学，他们也不希望，他们有他们自己的观念。
So just leave them and find people who are willing, who are interested to hear.
把他们放在一边，我们去找一些喜欢聆听我们的人。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Sati Mataji. 请问 Gurudev， 在圣典博加瓦坛，第五篇十五章第六节是讲，为什么在 Gaya 王出生之前 ，Sukadeva Goswami 不厌其烦地介绍了他祖先一代一代的出生，这有什么意义吗？Let me check. 第五篇第十五章十六节。I want to ask a good name. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, fifth canto, chapter 15, verse 6, why the Gaya Maharaj, before he born, Sukadeva Goswami, speak about his ancestor, and there are some special meaning.
Well, they all appeared long before Sukadeva Goswami.
Sorry, Gurudev.
They all appeared, all these kings, they appeared long before Sukadeva Goswami.
这些国王都是显现。Sorry, Gurudev.Long before, 在 Sukadeva Goswami 显现以前的。
Yeah, because we're talking about the descendants of Priyavrata.
我们在这里讲述的是 Priyavrata 的这个后裔。
So Priyavrata, he's from the Satya Yuga.
Priyavrata, 他是 Satya Yuga 的。
And then,
显现在 Satya Yuga.
Then Lord Rishabdev comes, and Lord Rishabdev, I think he's in the Treta Yuga.
主 Rishabhadeva 他是 Tritya Yuga。
So these kings were millions of years ago。
这些国王是几百万年前以前的。
So Sukadeva Goswami, he's just speaking about the history。
Sukadeva Goswami 讲述的是这些历史。
He's telling about the past。
他讲述过去的这一切。
Okay. Yeah.
Krishna Gurudev. 嗯，是的，我理解是他讲述的这些历史，但是因为在这个时节当中，就是他介绍了伽耶王出生之前，他的这些祖先，就是一代一代的出生，然后他的父母的名字，就是那妻子的名字，然后生了哪个儿子，然后他妻子又怀孕了，又生了哪个儿子，就是详细介绍了很多这些就是很多代的人的出生。
嗯哼，
我感觉这个好像跟这个伽耶王，没有什么太大的这个意义。就是对于伽耶王的出生，他可以不详细的介绍这么多的人名，我不知道有什么特殊意义吗？
No, just mentioning the names, just by mentioning the names of great kings is very purifying. They're not telling us anything about them, but just telling us names of this king and what their family and them. So it's for our purification.
只是介绍这些国王的名字都是一种净化，为了我们的净化。
Just like in the Bhagavad Gita, the first chapter, they have the names of so many great soldiers who are all there on the battlefield. So why did they mention the names of all these soldiers who are on the battlefield? It's for our purification.
就像在《博伽梵歌》的第一篇开始的时候，第一章开始的时候，为什么要讲那么多的战场上的那么多的士兵的名字呢？也是为了净化我们。
So the same way, here in the Bhagavad Gita,
因此是同样的道理。
We're hearing about all these different kings and their queen, their children. Okay, this is.To understand there is a line, there's so many kings, who, we may want to know, oh, who were the king, who were they? So they present the name, it's all there, it's recorded, it's part of the record.
我们了解他们的这个历史，它是这个传承，记录在这些里面。
They didn't tell us much about them, but they, you know, when came Gaya Maharaj, they talked more.Talked a lot about Maharaj Gaya.
我们虽然我们没有了解他们前面很多细节，但是我们也了解，就是讲述了更多的是关于 Gaya.
Just like in Chaitanya Charitamrita, they have the names of so many devotees of Lord Chaitanya.
就像在永恒的柴坦尼亚经。里面有很多的名字是主柴坦尼亚的奉献者。
We don't know everything about them, but you know we hear the name.
我们聆听他们的名字，但是我们并不知道他们的一些具体情况。
So just to understand, you know, that there are all these people. There, everything is personal. The people are there. What is the names? What they doing? We don't know.
我们虽然不知道他们的这些情况，但是我们可以理解，这都是人格性的。
嗯。Okay.
好的。
好。
好的，谢谢 Gurudev。
谢谢 Gurudev。
还有问题吗？
没有了，没有了。Oh, 目前我没有看到。
Okay.
对，没有问题了。嗯。
好，今天到这里。
好，谢谢顾问。
感谢，这里是布里罗给我们精彩的翻译。
哦，感谢顾问，
感谢萨蒂 ，future，
好，
感谢所有的奉献者聆听。 Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai. Hare Krishna.